If you're looking for a cheap and reliable way to buy your FIFA 23 Ultimate Team coins over Foot Birthday, then please look no further than FIFAcoin.com. You can get up to 12% discount and an extra 5% when you use my code Martin. Link will be in the description. Hi guys, Martin88 here, and welcome back to another FIFA 23 video. And I am very pleased to say that we are inching ever closer to Team of the Season, the most fun time of the year on FIFA. And today I am going to be looking at a Premier League Team of the Season prediction, which is always a fun one to do. This isn't my vote, it's just my prediction. I wanted to run through with you guys what I was thinking and let you know, and for you guys to tell me, sorry, whether you think I've made a mistake, who you think's going to be in it, all that great stuff. It's not going to be too long. Hopefully Community Tots is this Friday, and then Premier League would be next Friday, which would be magic. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. It's always a 4-3-3, so one goalkeeper, four defenders, three midfielders, and three attackers. The amount of players that they give in reserve always varies. They used to do a 23-man squad, and it's gone down. So I've put a few on the bench as well for honourable mentions who I think will get in as well. So, in goal for me, I think it'll be Nick Pope. Newcastle have been superb, and defensively they've been immense. The usual suspects, Alisson and Ederson, haven't hit their usual heights. I think Nick Pope will have a very good chance of getting the number one spot. In at right back, I've gone for Trippier. No, I'm not a Newcastle fan. I'm an Ipswich fan, for those of you that don't know. But 2 out of 2 for Newcastle here. Trippier's been brilliant for them. And ever since he's gone in, he's one of the players that's lifted that standard. Really good technically, scored some great goals for them as well. And also, there's not many options at right back across the league, if I'm being honest. I'm sure a lot of you would disagree. I mean, Trent had an absolute hammer in by the media and stuff like that, not really performed that well. Guardiola's been criticising Cole Walker. So yeah, there's not that many options. So Kieran Trippier, it is. Right, in at centre back, I'm gonna do both of these as a pair. I've gone for Saliba and Gabriel. Arsenal have been amazing, and these two have been extremely good for them defensively. You could argue maybe you could have a look at a Man City centre-half potentially, definitely like a Newcastle one. But I do think that with EA, they will want to mix it up. I know how they work, and I can see one of these being in it, and they'll come up with somebody else, so just know it. Okay, so these two. Then at left back, I've gone for Zinchenko. Again, at left back, I think there's so few options of who it could be. Newcastle fans would point at Dan Burn, but I think if Trippier and Pope get it, they're not going to do a third Newcastle defender. So yeah, for me, I'm going for Zinchenko, and he's like Trippier at Newcastle. Zinchenko coming to Arsenal is just one of the players that's lifted them to a whole new level. And I don't just mean ability-wise, I mean mentally as well. It'd be really intriguing if there's any Arsenal fans watching, what they think. But yeah, for me, Zinchenko has got a great shout at being the left back. Okay, into the midfield. And every single year is Kevin De Bruyne. You could argue he hasn't been as good this season as he has been on previous campaigns, but he's still been great. He's still if not the best central midfielder in the world for me. And there's not a planet that we're living on where I can't see him not getting a Team of the Season card. All I hope that he's got a little bit more pace than that Team of the Year card. Next one, Casemiro for me. I think there's been a hell of a lot of hype about how well he's been doing at Manchester United. And there was doubts when he come in. And also, it shouldn't all be like this, but if EA can fit in somebody from Manchester United, they will, because they want to sell packs and it pulls more interest. For me, I can see Casemiro again. And they always tend to have like a more defensive one. So it might be like in seasons gone by, like Declan Rice, Fabinho, Rodri, those kind of players. So, but I can see Casemiro getting it. Okay. Next one for me, and I'm actually quite excited for this one, is Martin Odegaard, who's Arsenal's captain. And if you have a look at stats in terms of goals and assists, he's been phenomenal. Plus, just to actually watch with your own eyes, he's a phenomenal player. Really enjoyed watching him this season. Plus, he's Arsenal's captain. Obviously, team of the season is going to come out. We're not going to know the fate of the Premier League title, but he could still be the one that's lifting that trophy at the end of the season. And my God, if he was, no one could doubt that he should be in the team of the season, in my opinion. All right, let's get up to the front three. So again, for me, this is quite a lot of Arsenal players. I get that, but they've been the shining light this season. Saka, I think, is a shoo-in on the right-hand side. His stats have been amazing. He's performed brilliantly, and I don't see anybody else getting in front of him, to be honest with you. As is this guy. I don't see anyone getting in front of this. This is what it says on the tin. People are still maybe a bit underwhelmed. That's the wrong word. They expect more. That because Haaland is so good, and I think people feel this Man City side isn't as good as what it has been in previous years when it's just been on a different level. They're still amazing, but not the unbelievable levels that they've been over the last, I don't know, 3, 4, 5 years or whatever. So therefore, maybe the way that people are looking at Haaland's season is a bit different. But he has scored bundles and bundles of goals. And I actually think that he'll have better seasons at Man City. He's scored a lot, but I think the gelling period of the club, and I mean this, the whole club, getting to know him and utilising him, I think will grow. And they will bring in players that will utilise him. And he is going to be in Premier League team of the season for many, many years to come. So hats off to Erling Haaland. On to the left, I think this is very deserved. Now, I think it'll be Marcus Rashford. As last season, he was absolutely atrocious. He's a bit injured at the moment, which is an awful shame. But this season, he has been electric for United. Right back to his best, which is lovely to see. And EA don't mind getting Rashford into a team of the season. They've done it on many other times. And like I said, the whole Manchester United link as well, because they want to sell packs. I can see Rashford getting in on the left. I really can. It pains me because nearly every year it's Heung-min Son. That's who I love to see in there, but he's not going to get it this year. So that's the starting 11. Let's have a look at a couple of honourable mentions. So I think that will there be 3 or 5 additional ones, in my opinion. Salah's not been as good as normal, but he's still got great stats. And it's the same for Harry Kane. Tottenham have been very disappointing. But Harry Kane's still going to score 25-plus goals this season. That's hard to not have him in there, you know. And other people would mention like Ollie Watkins or even Tony. But I just feel like EA will go with those big names. I think Martinelli's got a great shout getting one. He's been phenomenal for Arsenal. And a couple more Newcastle players here. Almiron and Bruno Guimaraes, who have been very good as well. But I can't quite see them overcoming the stars. So guys, there we go. There is my Premier League team of the season prediction. I'd really love a lot of comments on this, because that's what I enjoy. Chew the fat, debate. Have I got it right? Have I got it wrong? Who do you think is going to be in there? Let me know. But guys, that's it for today. So please drop a like on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.